My name is Kathy, Katayun Attaii. I live in Los Angeles. I'm a private banker, senior vice president of Comerica Bank, private banking entertainment. I've been doing this for since the 1980s, and most of my portfolio is within the entertainment industry, and the rest of it is the Persian community in the Los Angeles area. I got involved with the Iranian-American Women's Conference through my good friend, my childhood friend, Mariam Khosravani, whose efforts within the Iranian community and outside has always inspired me. So whenever she calls me to order or to help, I am only happy to be there. And my participation, I initially thought the idea was great, but I didn't realize how great it was until the conference. And now I am personally passionate about it. She did a great job recruiting a lot of accomplished, wonderful Iranian-American women who attended the conference and did a great job, and I am happy to be a part of it from this point on. At the day of the conference, as I met so many women and as I sat and listened to the panelists that brought different experiences, and they shared so much of themselves, and each of them were different, and they were inspiring their own rights. That's when I really realized the power of the conference. And I just loved being there, and I was just taking it all in. And I know the people that I spoke with, the women that I spoke with, that feeling was shared among so many people. And I think that lays the power of this conference, to have all those experiences shared and to hear all those wonderful life stories and to know that you can come from different walks of life and bring different skill sets. And as long as you're passionate about what you do and you're excited about life and work and just bring that level of excitement to everything you do, there is no one formula to success. And as long as you put one foot in front of the other the next day and you do it with passion and purpose, you can accomplish whatever you set out to accomplish. And I think that message was very clear throughout the day from different people that attended the conference. There was no one highlight. Everything about the conference was so inspiring and so empowering, and I'm going to use the word love because that's how you felt. You felt so connected to all these women that were so accomplished, and they were all there to share the same story. At the end of the day, it was the same story: to be committed to what you do, to be passionate, and then to share the wealth, share the knowledge and the experience with one another. So at the end of the day, I came away thinking my cup was full. And it was such a great feeling to have. And you could sense that around the crowd, all women, all, particularly younger women who attended. So I think it was a major success. Establishing the conference and having it be a part of our culture here going forward, it's very important. Part of it is because we have so many accomplished women, Iranian-American women, that have come here over the last 20, 30 years since we all migrated here, that have done tremendous. And I feel a lot of it has been done quietly. And there has never been such a vehicle to connect all of us, not only to give recognition, to have that networking built, and also to inspire the younger generation of Iranian-American women to learn, and for us to be mentors, and for us to just make our voices heard more. So I think it's very important to have something like this that we all connect with, and we use it as a networking system and more. You know, there is always the talk, that has always been the talk, that women's place in society has been neglected, and women need to be recognized more, and women need to accomplish more. And I think there is a lot of truth into that, but at the same time, I think women are doing tremendous, especially in the U.S. The work is far from over, and there is a lot more room for growth in terms of education and accomplishment. But I think every single woman that does well and accomplishes well, you know, paves the way for other women. And I think in the society, young girls, and happily, young boys are very supportive of the idea of equality. And I don't think that's the issue anymore. And the glass ceiling seems to be cracking and breaking one glass at a time, and it's making a huge difference. I think still there is a lot more work to be done, but I think having women in the society and having accomplished and powerful women changes the whole makeup of the society, and it makes it a lot more balanced, because women bring to the table different qualities than men do, and that is not to say which one is better or worse. I think they complement one another, and that's why it's so essential. And the more women that enter the workforce, especially in more sensitive positions, you'll see the world getting a much better place and having a more equilibrium in the corporate environment. Always been supportive of the idea of women helping women, and because I have along the way in my career, I have met a lot of amazing women who have inspired me one way or another, and there wasn't one mentor or one particular woman that just changed my life. There were little pieces of so many women that I took away so much from. And that's why I think it's so important. And I have tried to do the same along my way with every woman that I've ever worked with, every individual, particularly women, to share that kind of a gift, to share that experience. Because as I said, there is no one particular woman or one particular story that has touched me and taught me a lot in life. There's been so many of them. And I try to do the same as I work every day and as I come in contact with younger women. The MC of a segment at the last conference, the last panel, I was the MC, and I was very glad to be a part of the conference, not only to participate, just to MC one segment of the program. And you had just tons and tons of accomplished women in each segment, and you didn't want to miss any of them. So, and I think the feeling was shared, because there was each of them, they brought different sets of talents and mentality and mindset and experience that you just wanted to just like observe all of it and hear what they had to say and get inspired and see how you can apply that to your own life. So I think that energy was very high that day, and I think it's very important to, as was well said, to keep the fire going. And I think having repetition of this conference is gathering more women, because I know since the last conference, the word of mouth, I keep hearing it from everybody who has missed it and all the women that want to attend the next one. I think that is how you keep the fire burning and the energy going, to have all these women being in constant communications and to see how we can make the next conference better and bigger and make it not only an annual thing, a big part of our corporate life, whether we're in the corporate life or any kind of a professional life. I think the purpose of this conference is to connect, to recognize all the accomplished Iranian-American women who have done it over the last 20 or 30 years, a lot of them quietly, and to give them the recognition and to have this networking of connecting all of us to further our careers, to learn from each other, and I think most importantly, to inspire the new Iranian-American generation of women coming up in the U.S. and I think ultimately globally. And I see that happening with this conference, because everybody that has attended the conference has been quite passionate. And if we can keep the passion going and keep the attendance more and more people are involved and more people are connected, I think we can all benefit from it tremendously. That's where I think the excitement is. Everybody's looking forward to the next conference to see who else you can connect with and how you can give the message to all women. Right.